We're going to cover the basics of electricity. We're going to discuss four basic terms dealing with the current, the pressure, the resistance, and the power of electricity. These are measured in amperes, voltage, ohms, and watts. Current, which is measured in amperes or amps, are electrons in motion that result in electrical current. A conductor is commonly used as a pathway, often a copper wire. The greater the number of electrons passing a given point in a circuit, the greater the intensity of the current, the greater the amps. Just like gallons per minute in a water flow. 1 amp is equal to this number on the screen. That's 16 zeros of electrons per second. Voltage is the measurement of pressure. In a similar way that water pressure in a pipe is measured in pounds per square inch, the amount of pressure in electrical current is measured in voltage. Voltage theoretically remains constant in a number of standards. You'll see 120 volts, 208 volts, 240 volts, 347 volts in Canada, 480 volts, and 600 volts. Resistance is measured in ohms. The property of a material which causes it to oppose the movement of electrons is called resistance. Materials which offer little resistance to electron movement are called conductors, wires of copper, aluminum, etc. Those which offer higher resistance are called non-conductors or insulators and are typically made of things like ceramic, glass, or plastics. Resistance is measured in ohms. Power is the base unit and measured in watts. When you multiply the amps times the volts, the result is watts, the total amount of energy in a circuit at a given moment. V times A is equal to W. 1,000 watts is equal to 1 kilowatt. Here's an example of a power calculation. A 120 volt lighting system has a current draw of 9 amps. How much power is being consumed by the lighting system? Well, power, watts, is equal to the pressure, volts, times the current, amps. Therefore, 120 volts times 9 amps is equal to 1,080 watts. Another example of power calculation, if you have a 120 volt lighting system that consumes 600 watts of power, what is the current flowing through the wire? If watts is equal to volts times amps, therefore, amps would be equal to watts divided by volts. 600 watts divided by 120 volts is equal to 5 amps. In summation, the current, which is similar to the amount of water flowing, is measured in amps. Voltage, which is similar to the force of the water, is measured in volts. Resistance, which is the narrowness of the pipe or our sprinkler, is measured in ohms. The power is the rate at which the water flows, and that's measured in watts. And that's electricity simplified. Amps, or the flow of electricity, are very similar to this flow of water measured in gallons per minute. The water is flowing much like electricity flows, hence that's amperage. Voltage is a little bit different than amperage. Voltage is the force of the water. I have greater voltage there. I can increase the amperage or increase the voltage. Resistance, measured in ohms, can be like wire or a lighting fixture or luminaire. In this case, the resistance, or ohms, is caused by my sprinkler head. It's resisting the electricity. Watts, which is the rate of flow of electricity, is akin to this sprinkler head that I have here. This is volts times amps, which is equal to power, which is measured in watts.